everyone. Hate starting the show off on a sad note. This got to be done. We've lost a few legends. Off the bat, thank you to my good friend Renee Phillips. I had no idea about this lady, but I know you do. Pat Wardell. Now, she was the original Bobby Joe Bradley on Petticoat Junction. My mother used to watch that show when she was young. Petticoat Junction, very popular show. The original Bobby Joe Bradley. Pat Wardell was born July 12, 1944. Passed away back on September 29, 2015 at the age of 71. She had cancer for 20 years. And sadly passed away. So definitely a sad loss indeed. No doubt about that. And then this one. Caught this while I was watching the episode of Prosper. And then my friend Renee Phillips let me know. Yep, Justin Dimmitt's show, Prosper. Very important watching. Of course, he honored this man. This is Bruce Hyde, folks. Bruce Hyde, he played Lieutenant Kevin Riley on the original Star Trek, the original series that ran from 1966 to 1969. Bruce Hyde was born September 14th, 1941. Passed away October 13th in 2015 at the age of 74. Yep, he passed away from cancer as well. But, folks, as sad as those are, this is the one that breaks my heart right here. See, another co-worker of mine passed away, folks. My man Lawrence Ross, Lowdown Dirty Ross, this bubble-chasing badass son of a gun, great friend, great family man, like a brother to me. Lawrence Ross, Lowdown Dirty Ross, born March 27th, 1990, and passed away Sunday morning in a car wreck at the much too young age of only 25 years old. Left behind his awesome wife, Kayla, who I worked with as well down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, and their wonderful, wonderful baby girl, Layla, only a year old. An incredible family, broken apart by a horrible accident. Lawrence Ross, I love you, man. I know you're in a better place. I definitely miss you. We all miss you. And working with this young man for 4 years was an honor, a privilege, a blessing. And Lowdown Dirty Ross, big time Redskins fan from Virginia originally. Oh yeah. Miss talking football with you every Sunday. And now I know why we weren't able to talk football yesterday. A sad day, a sad loss. Lowdown Dirty Ross, I know we're going to keep on living, brother. And tonight's show is dedicated to you. Folks, moment of silence, please, for these great folks. Obviously, Pat Wardell, Bruce Hyde, but of course, my man, Lawrence Ross, Lowdown Dirty Ross, a true friend for life. All right. Wow. This is hard, folks. This is hard. But you know, show's got to go on. Ooh. Your friends wouldn't have it any other way. Hang tight. That's right, baby. You know it. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Monday. October 19th in the year of our Lord, 2015. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Blues Monday. I know it doesn't sound like blues, but you know what? The great Chuck Berry had his 89th birthday yesterday. I recorded Football Sunday yesterday, and I wanted to honor my man Chuck Berry today. That's right, Johnny B. Goode. Recorded December 29th, 30th, 1957. An absolute classic. He's my all-time favorite musician in history. That's right, the original, baby. Wow. Okay, well, got some unofficial sponsors of our show. Gotta give it up to my man, Remy LaCascio, phenomenal real estate legend, very dear friend, and folks who that remember him, 4 months ago, he lost his own wife, my dear friend, Leanne LaCascio. She passed away in a motorcycle wreck. Remy, he's you know, obviously grieving every day still, but by God, he's living. Leanne wouldn't have it any other way. Remy LaCascio, very dear friend, phenomenal real estate legend, and Remy, brother, it's a rough day, bro. You know that. You've been down that road. And, you know, we know Leanne and Lawrence Ross, they want us to keep living. It's the only way to live. Keep on living life every single day. Alright, gotta give it to my friends over at Philo Liquors, of course. That's like an everyday thing, pretty much, and the right thing to do. Because today's beer of the day, they gave me first dibs on it, and we're bringing it out. Philo Liquors, great place for great quality adult beverages. Alright, here it is. Been waiting for the right day to rock this here beer. Luckenbach beer out of Austin, Yeehaw, Texas. Came with a guitar pick, and I don't know what I did with it, but I ain't got time to look for it. Yes, came for a guitar pick, perfect for Chuck Berry. Luckenbach beer, South Austin Brewery, down in Austin, Austin, Texas. This has a whopping 7% alcohol by volume, full pint size, 16 ounces. So let's bust out the Hard Rock Cafe San Antonio beer consumption apparatus. Private opening apparatus, pump technique, here we go. We're going to roll right through the songs. I said Blues Monday, we're bringing it out. The B-side of his first single, May 21st, 1955. Wee Wee Hours, a real classic. Oh yeah, this is blues at its finest, folks. 45 to grand, right in the big, subject to that brass, right on the keyboard. Because I'm that damn good, I haven't been dropped yet, never have, never will.
That's what I think of you.
Oh, Chuck Berry with a voice as smooth as the late, great Charles Brown. And if anybody knows what real rhythm and blues is all about, Charles Brown was a legend. Cheers to the best, all you Prussia, Germany, compadres, and Saint Japan, Leon Licascio and Lawrence Ross. God bless you both. Rest in peace. And miss you so much.
You say, but yet I wonder if your love was ever true.
Oh. Oh. This is better than I thought it would be. This is what a Bach beer is supposed to be all about. Wow. This is magnificent. This is,
Think of you.
I'm giving it a big solid A. I love this beer a lot.
In a wheeling room.
All right. A lot of birthdays to get to. Right off the bat, my good friend. Now he goes by the name Parts. Am I right? No, Paris Leather. Jeez, Parts, really? Parts Paris. Hey, you know it's close, right? Paris Leather. Now he's a great friend of my wicked awesome buddy. Jonel Gihama, better known as G. That's right. And Paris Leather, what's going on, bud? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday to you. Hope you're living it up. Hope you're celebrating well. Living in Turkey. Hell of a country right there. Lots of great shopping too, I might add. Well, Paris Leather, happy birthday, my friend. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And a cheers of beers. And G, I'm giving you a shout out as well. Because thank you for leading me to Paris Leather, a great man indeed. G, I miss working with you on the job site down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Hell yeah, brother. All right, next on the list. A wonderful sweetheart of a lady I know from good old Falmouth, Massachusetts. Her awesome husband, Kevin's a Masonic brother. And a lovely, amazing Karen Thayer. Karen, how are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And I hope Kevin's spoiling you right. I hope you two are getting your drink on, having a lot of fun, enjoying today. Hey, it's only four more days till Figgin' Friday. Remember that. So enjoy today. Enjoy every day. Karen, happy birthday, my friend. I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers.
The one I really love.
Next on the list, this guy is a former Amway distributor that I met over 20 years ago. I met him in 1995. In fact, I was wearing a halo. I had a broken neck at the time. I came a half an inch from being quadriplegic, which is exactly why I embrace and enjoy life every day. I'll tell you what, Randy Haugen. Let's get to some berry picking real quick. Next song, gotta roll right through these. I wanna keep the show 35 minutes or less. But Randy Haugen, thank you for the recent ad as a friend on the old Facebook. I got to drop you a line, let me know, and tell you that life is absolutely a blessing. It is phenomenal. And you were such an inspiration during those days when we were Amway distributors. My God, you and your awesome wife, Val, an absolute sweetheart. You two are an incredible couple from Utah. That's right, Utah. And Randy and Valerie Haugen, miss you both so much. Miss those good old days. And Randy, very, very successful. Randy and Val Haugen, very successful in their own personal businesses. He's not involved in Amway anymore. He's doing other adventures. And Randy, happy birthday, my friend. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. God bless you, my friend. And thank you for your awesome inspiration. I learned so much from you. You and Val. All right, next on the list, my man, Brian Jasik, J-A-S-I-K. I know Brian through our good friend Sal Capaccio and our late, great buddy, Johnny Vaughn. Oh, God. Hey, Brian, boy, do we miss Johnny or what, huh? But Brian, happy birthday to you, my friend. How's life treating you? I hope you're doing well. And I haven't heard from you in a while. So I'll drop you a line and say, how you doing, man? Well, that's what I'm doing on Baron Song today. Give me some love from yours truly, the love of Dr. Reverend Dr. B. That's what I do. And Brian, happy birthday, my friend. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, a fellow Masonic brother. This guy is an incredible chef, restaurant owner, friend, Jim Murray. Jim Murray, oh yeah, with the greatest name for a restaurant I've ever known, the Nimrod, an incredible restaurant in Falmouth, Massachusetts. Jim Murray, happy birthday to you, my friend, you Nimrod, ha ha, all good fun. Hey, I know you don't get on the old Facebook a whole lot, I hope you get on soon, I'd love to hear from you. Squeeze me, miss you big time, but hey, slap my brother in the head when you see him. Just tell him it's from me, why not, right? Jim Murray, happy birthday, my friend. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. All right. Bringing out from 1956. Brown-Eyed Handsome Man. You just heard Barry Pickett from 1955. Oh, yeah. The original version of Brown-Eyed Handsome Man. Well, I'm a blue-eyed, horrifying-looking man, but you know what? I live with it. Thank God my wife had a contact install backwards, which she meant me. Next birthday, my good friend Sean Sampson. Longtime friend of mine on the old Facebook, fellow Mafia Wars legend. And Sean, what's going on, bud? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Love the Mafia Wars. We have a lot of fun. Baby, we're getting rid of the pent-up frustration of a hard day at work. Get home, ice some fools. Nobody gets hurt for real, only some bruised egos. But Sean, happy birthday. Hope you have an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Alright. Next on the list, my man Buster A. Roll. Another fellow mafioso, a more recent addition to the crew. Buster, what's going on, brother? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday's been phenomenal so far. Hope it becomes wicked awesome. Méchant Chenille. French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Canada, indeed. God, I used to love my neighbors up north, and I do down on Baron Song today every single day of the week. Buster A. Roll, happy birthday, my man. Hope y'all working awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. All right. Final birthday shout out goes to my good friend Brent Best. Now, her younger sister Amber, that we know from jolly old England, my daughter's best friend while we were living in England, and they're still in touch all the time. And Brett, a wonderful, wonderful young lady, no doubt about it, a walking brain of a lady living in Iowa. Happy birthday to you, Brett. How's life treating you? I hope you're doing well. We all miss you big time. You're always welcome to come visit. Come visit Casa de Love Goddess. Get some world famous cooking again, like the old days. Well, Brett, happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and apple juice to you. I don't think you're quite old enough to drink adult beverages yet. If I'm wrong, you let me know. All right, so there it is. That's our birthday shout-outs for today. We had ourselves... Oh, my God, before I get to anything further. I forgot to mention... Hey, you know, it's hard to be on your A-game when you lose a very close friend. It really is. But you know what? You got to keep plugging. So, without further ado, I bring to you... Did you know that today is... Happy National Seafood Bisque Day. Bisque. B-I-S-Q-U-E. It's like some sort of seafood sauce or something like that, I guess. I don't know. I'm not a big seafood guy. I mean, I see food and eat it. That's my kind of seafood, but... Oh, nah. Yeah. No. And then we do have National Clean Your Virtual Desktop Day. Are you kidding me? Third Monday in October. Ha! Well, if your virtual desktop's a mess, celebrate. virtual clean your desktop day, or a national clean your virtual desktop day. Yeah, something like that. Whatever. Mine's not that messy, so believe it or not, my desk is a disaster, but hey, it's all good. All right. So anyway, we did have ourselves a pretty doggone good trivia question, and bear with me, and I will bring it to you, okay? So, without further ado, here we go. This duck-walking legend turned 89 years old on October 18th and is still going strong. It all started with Maybelline on May 21st, 1955 and hasn't stopped since. Who is this rock and roll legend? By the way, he's still doing the duck walk to this day. Our good friends, Lucky Windsor Dimmitt, that's right, of Okinawa, Japan. An incredible duo of dogs. Oh yeah, Lucky Windsor Dimmitt. They said, Chuck Berry! Very excited about it too. Woof! You answer Smurf absolutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job, Lucky Windsor Dimmitt. And I beat. I got the salute to you. Oh, hell yeah! There you go. And I hope your owners, Justin and Robin, give you some treats because you earned it. Like Smith Barney, you made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Hell yeah. Let's drink to that. A couple dogs that are phenomenal. All right. Now, time to announce our fan of the week. That's right. Oh, God. I slipped on that. Our fan of the week winner for week number 119, if I'm not mistaken, is a name you all know very well. He brought multiple friends to follow Beer and Song in a Day, and he shared every single show, every single album, every single picture within the past week. Our man, the pride of West Virginia, the man, the myth, the legend, Willie Holt. Willie, brother, always appreciate the support that you give. You support like a double D bra. Underwire. That support. Willie Holt, thank you for your support. I give you the love, not the salute. Oh, hell yeah! There you go. Willie Holt, you reek of exquisite, wicked awesomeness, my friend. And a big hearty cheers and beers to you. All right, now let's get to some more music, shall we? Dang it, I lost my place and I was worried about that. Oh, my daughter's name's Delilah, and this was from 1958. It's called Beautiful Delilah. That's right, a great song. Now, I just remembered I got additional shout-outs I gotta give. I knew there was a reason for everything here. It's gonna be about a 35-minute show. So hang tight, it'll be well worth watching, I promise you that. We gotta get some additional shout-outs. My man Drew Thomas. Drew, you and your album, epic! Drew Thomas is a friend of mine, he's a stand-up comic, professional stand-up comic, and he opens for birthday boy Rodney Carrington. That's right, if y'all ain't heard of Rodney Carrington, you're cheating yourselves. Drew Thomas, brother, it's always a pleasure to chat with you. He's a big-time, wicked, hardcore Atlanta Falcons fan and a professional comic. And I need you to do me a favor, Drew. You let Rodney Carrington know that yours truly, the love, Dr. Reverend Dr. B, Josh Baker, says happy 47th birthday, because Rodney is 47 and a gift sent from heaven. No doubt about that. And Drew Thomas, brother, you're a gift sent from heaven too, bro. Always great chatting with you. How about them Falcons, 6-0? Wow! Very impressed with that. No, I lied. Shit. They lost. My bad. All right, they're still a damn good football team. Drew Thomas, you rock, brother. Want to give you a shout out. And Rodney Carrington, happy birthday. Drew and Rodney, what a dynamic duo of exquisite, wicked awesomeness right there. All right, gotta give it up to a couple three great folks that are tied in with my good friend, Lowdown Dirty Ross. Now, obviously, Kayla, I don't even know what to say, Kayla. I don't know how you're doing it. I know you're focusing on the future. I know you're there for your baby girl. And you know we're all here for you. No doubt about it. If you need anything, Kayla Ross, we got you covered like a blanket. I promise you that. Definitely missed the hell out of you. And I know you're coming back to visit. And I know it's not for the right reasons. But you know what? We're all here for you. We are family. Sister Sledge sang it well in 1979. And it's truth. It really is. We are family. Squeeze me. Kayla, cheers the best to you, my dear.
My baby beside me at the wheel.
Chuck Berry's No Particular Place to Go, 1965. Jessica Bonilla, great chat with you today. Now, Jessica Bonilla is an amazing young lady. She's a cop I know from jolly old England. And when I moved to Yeehaw, Texas, and I met the Honorable Lawrence Ross, I found out that Lawrence and Jessica actually went to high school together in Alexandria, Virginia. Folks, it's a small world. And Jessica, I know you're sad. You know I'm sad. And Lawrence was just an amazing guy, wasn't he? You're damn right he was. And I grieve with you, and I want you to know, if you need anything, hit me up, all right? Jessica Bonilla, you're a sweetheart, you're an awesome friend, and a big hearty cheers to bears for you. Another guy I just met online, I haven't even talked to him yet, he sent me a friend request. His name, M. Phasis, P-H-A-S-I-S, and an onic, or on, onult, O-N-L-T. I don't know what that means, M. Phasis, onult, onult, M. Phasis on Lieutenant, hell, I don't know. But hey, I want to thank you for the friend request, and I want you to know, he's got two mutual friends, and that'd be Lawrence Ross and Jessica Bonilla. So obviously, you've known Lawrence longer than I have, man. Anything you can tell me, anything you need, I'm there for you, man. Because I'll tell you what, we lost a great friend. No doubt about that. So hey, I want to give you a shout out on Baron's Song of the Day. And I want you to know, Lawrence would want us to stay strong. And he wants us to keep on living, baby. You got to live every day to the fullest. That's what we do. Alright, so with that said, I want to make sure I haven't missed anyone. Alright, Jeremy Ramirez, a badass crypto! I work with out here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as. That's right, West Louisiana, pretty much the same state. Jeremy, good chat with you today. Oh, hey, thank you for the ad on the old Facebook. I wasn't able to send you a friend request, but you had that blocked for some reason, and you said your wife probably did it. Anyway, you're blaming it on the better half. It's all good, though. Yeah, that's why my wife and I don't share a Facebook page. Hell no. Ain't no way in hell my wife would share a Facebook page with me. She's pretty quiet on the old Facebook, and I never shut up. How about 30 Days, Chuck Berry, 1955? But Jeremy, dude, you're a badass, an awesome guy, and a legend I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, although I know it's northern Mexico, pretty much the same damn country. Jeremy Ramirez, a big cheers to be here for you. Now, I got a few shout-outs saved for when I feature them. We have a real babe of the day for Baron's Song of the Day, and you all are going to love that. We got a real pet of the day on Baron's Song of the Day, and I'll give her some love when her dog's featured. And then we've also got a guy who gets a load to my good friends, John and his wonderful better half, Rebecca Peterson. John and Rebecca Peterson. Now, John, I know you're a big-time Chuck Berry fan. You're a big-time blues nut, big-time blues aficionado like me. Hell yeah, brother. This guy fixes weapons for a living. Worked side-by-side with our good friend Kayla Ross, who just moved to South Korea recently. Taking her talents to South Korea, making that country better. But, John Peterson, dude, hey, told you to go get some love on Baron's Song of the Day. Why? I went every other way. And Rebecca, I'll tell you what, John better be spoiling you rotten each and every single day. Take him from the love doctor. A happy wife made for a happy life, all right? So, yeah, to the two of you, I'll give you a cheers of beer. Oh, yeah. All right. I'm going to start rolling into, I got to work things perfectly. The next song is where I'm going to start featuring some pictures. I got to get 10 songs out there. 10! You can't have 9. It's like the Ten Commandments. See, George Carlin had a rant about the Ten Commandments. I agree, though. You can't have 9 or 8 or something like that. Nah, he said you only needed 2, but hey, you know. 10's a good number. It's whole. It's wholesome. All right. Let's talk some celebrity birthdays real quick. How about Floyd Mayweather Sr.?
Yeah.
Yeah, Floyd Mayweather Sr. 63 years old today. Michael Gambon. G-A-M-B-O-N. He's most famous as Harry Potter. Michael Gambon is 75 years old today. A milestone, 75 years old. Listen to this one. No Money Down. Chuck Berry, 1955. More blues at its finest. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know what? Harry Potter. You know, maybe if he came out of his basement once in a while, he might get a little lucky with a lovely lady. Harry Potter. I have no use for him in my life. I'm sorry, but I know there's some Harry Potter fans out there. But Harry Potter is all... The only difference between Harry Potter and Justine Bieber is that Harry Potter at least isn't causing bad things. Justine Bieber is a waste of life. Enough said on that. All right, let's focus on the positive. How about Trey Parker? Trey Parker! Oh, yeah! 46 years old today! Trey Parker and Matt Stone? What did they create? My daughter's favorite show now, South Park. That's right, Trey Parker. There you go, 46 today. Jose Bautista, Toronto Blue Jays slugger, 35 years old today. Awesome stuff. Oh, yeah. You want to talk about cars? Here we go. How about this? Chuck Berry's classic 1973 Cadillac Eldorado Fleetwood convertible. Oh, yeah. Chuck Berry loved his Cadillacs. And this one's a beauty. 1973, my year of birth. That's right. That's a beauty right there. And that was featured in his 1986 autobiographical film, Hail, Hail, Rock and Roll. Beautiful car. God, I wish I had that, huh? They sure don't make them like they used to, you know? How about today's instrument of the day? Yeah, gotta go with Chuck Berry's Gibson guitar. Chuck Berry, an absolute icon, a legend, an incredible guitarist. One of the original charter members of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio in 1986. Beautiful guitar. This picture, I know, because I personally saw this happen. This was September 1997 at the Long Beach Blues Festival. I was there. I got to see Chuck Berry doing the duck walk. I got to see Bo Diddley just nailing it. And 80-year-old John Lee Hooker tearing it up. I got to see those three legends. That day, I was sporting wood so hard, it was ridiculous. John Peterson, I don't think I've told you that story. But yes, the Long Beach Blues Festival 1997, the Love Doctor was there to see Chuck Berry, just like that, with Bo Diddley and John Lee Hooker. Now, my good friend Kelly Foy, she's a former Real Babe of the Day multiple times. She's one of our former admins of Beer and Song of the Day. And Kelly, remember this, my friend. You always are welcome to request whatever you want to see on Beer and Song of the Day. Because you are very special to me. Kelly Floyd just adopted an incredible dog. His name is Alfie. Oh, yeah. Kelly, I love it. And I'm very happy about that. He's an incredible young doggy. No doubt about that. Kelly Floyd, you're a sweetheart. How about them Patriots? Did you have to wear your lucky shoes last night? Your magic shoes? Or did we just win without needing luck? Get it? Anyway, there's your dog, Alfie. That's our real pet of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Oh, hell yeah. Kelly, let's drink to that, shall we, my friend? All right. Hang tight, folks. Very important text message. There's a rule. You don't ever ignore the love goddess, okay? Chicken pot pies. My wife asked, what's for dinner? All right, we got to get this one done because I got to get those ovens rolling because my wife will cut my throat if I don't. All right, time to bring out today's Babe of the Day. Oh, Hunk of the Day on Beer and Song of the Day. My personal Chuck Berry favorite song of all time from late 1955. You can't catch me. This song rocks. Yes, it does. And I just lost my place again. I feature this song on Beer and Song of the Day many times. Obviously, it's on the great 28 Chuck Berry 1984 album. If you ain't got this one and you love Chuck Berry, this is a great starter album. I have the 9 CD box set of Chuck Berry, Charlie Records. 9 CD box set, everything he recorded for Chess Records and on from 1955 to 1965. Chuck Berry, a legend, a badass. My all-time favorite musician ever. Hey, Robert Reedus. Well, he's celebrating a birthday in a different area known as heaven. Robert Reed, of course, we all remember him as Mike Brady on the Brady Bunch. Born in 1932, passed away in 1992 at the age of 59. Evander, the real deal, Holyfield. 53 years old today. Ty Pennington. From the TV show Extreme Makeover Home Edition. I love that show. I gotta admit, I'm a sucker for that one. Ty Pennington, a class act, 51 years old today. Sonny Deol, D-E-O-L. He is basically the action hero of Bollywood, Indian films, from India. 59 years old today. Action king of Bollywood. How about Divine? Yeah, Divine. Cross-dressing actor. He, she, I don't know. Born in the state in 1945, passed away to much too young age of 42 in 1988. Famous on the movie Hairspray. John Lithgow, also born in the state in 1945. Thankfully, he's still with us. Loved him in Third Rock from the Sun. A great actor indeed. Loved him in the Twilight Zone, the movie. He was great in that one. How about, listen to this guy, Cassius Clay. Cassius Clay, he was a Kentucky politician, white guy, abolitionist, was very much against slavery, and wrote a newspaper on abolishing slavery, and had death threats. Yes, he did. Cassius Clay, born in the state in 1810, passed away at the age of 92 in 1903. Doing that duck walk, there you go. Chris Kattan, actor, 45 years old today. How about can't read my own writing? Omar Gooding, of course, the younger brother of Cuba Gooding Jr. Omar Gooding, 39 years old today. Awesome stuff. Peter Tosh. Now, my good friend Lawrence Ross was a big reggae fan, big Bob Marley fan, and I know he is familiar with Peter Tosh. Peter Tosh, born in the state in 1944, sadly murdered at the age of 42 in 1987. Very heartbreaking right there. Incredible reggae legend. Played with Bob Marley and the Wailers. Ronnie Carrington, already mentioned him. 47 years old today. God, I love that guy. And Texas Rangers badass baseball player Michael Young, 39 years old today. There you go. Captain Chuck Berry, a legend, an icon, guitar beast. Oh, yeah. Chuck doing the duck walk. There it is. Marty McFly made it famous in Back to the Future. That's right. But Chuck Berry was the original, the icon, the legend, the BMF, bad mofo. That's right. And boy, oh boy, it's going to be a sad day when he passes away. He is in incredible shape for his age. Hey, maybe slaying lungs. I don't think he slays lungs anymore, but tell you what, he's still getting it, still rocking it. There he is, older and bolder. Look how young he was there, huh? Wow. That's him nowadays. Looking sharp. Mighty sharp. Chuck Berry, a legend and icon. I drink to that. And finally, folks, it's time for the moment of truth. Our real babe of the day. And a great song we play for her. The song is called Together We Will Always Be, a love song for a lovely lady. Chuck Berry, 1955. Sam Valdez, a stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady that works over at Philo Liquors. Sam, I love you, girl. You are a 283 Jolie. You are very pretty.
But what could I do?
Good God. And she's a total sweetheart. And my good friend Solomon Mack. Solomon, I got a question for you. Are you a former... did I ever feature you as Real Hunk of the Day on Bears on the Day? I gotta know. Because see, I couldn't remember if I did or not. But if I haven't, we're going to feature you as Real Hunk of the Day on Bear Song of the Day. Because you and Sam are good friends. Yes, you are. And this girl, oh yeah, Sam, you freaking rock, girl. Yeah, you do.
That you were so lonely.
Good God. Austin, 1987, Black Monday, I remember this well. Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped 508.32 points. 22%! That is an all-time record. It was four times the previous record. Thankfully, that record still stands, if I'm not mistaken. Also on the day in 1987, check this out, folks. Woody Woodward resigns as New York Yankees general manager. Lou Piniella named general manager. Billy Martin named New York Yankees manager for the fifth and final time. Golly. Billy Martin, hell of a manager. Always getting fired by George Steinbrenner, though. On this day in 1982, legendary car maker John DeLorean arrested on cocaine charges. I remember that one. He was found not guilty. But sadly, I think the DeLorean didn't last longer because of that arrest. On this day in 1980, Steve McPeak rides a unicycle. The unicycle, 101 feet 9 inches tall. I couldn't even ride a unicycle a couple feet tall. No way in hell. I've tried riding a unicycle. I don't know how people do it. I can't do it. I got better ways of doing things. Try a bicycle. On this day in 1975, Chorus Line opens at Schubert Theater, New York City. Ran for 6,137 performances. I think that's a record. If it's not, it's the second most ever. On this day in 1963, the Beatles recorded their legendary song, I Want to Hold Your Hand. Wow, hello. On this day in 1960, France grants Mauritania independence. Happy Independence Day, Mauritania. On this day in 1959, Florence Henderson joins the Today Show panel. Wow, Florence Henderson, that's right. Carol Brady from the Brady Bunch. Wow, who knew? She used to be a newscaster. The Today Show. On this day in 1954, very famous TV channel, KAKE TV, Cake TV, Channel 10, Wichita, Kansas, ABC affiliate begins broadcasting. On this day in 1941, first woman jockey in North America, Anna Lee Wiley in Mexico. On this day in 1926, the day after Chuck Berry was born, John C. Garand patents the semi-automatic rifle. On this day in 1919, Red Sox beat the White Sox 5-3 in the World Series. The series, obviously known as the Black Sox Scandal, 8 players accused of throwing the World Series. Yet, shoeless Joe Jackson batted .375 in the World Series. And finally, on this day in 1722, oh, a couple more. French C. Hopfer patents the fire extinguisher, and a big one for all of us Americans. General Cornwallis surrenders at Yorktown at 2 p.m. on this day in 1781. The Revolutionary War ends. I will drink to that. America! Damn right! Let's drink. Let's slam it home. Emptiest brain cells of an average Los Angeles Lakers fan. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, remember that to be. Folks, time to make a fetus to head out. Somebody take out. We're going to have some night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't you drive my spirit, drink all you might, kill yourself or somebody else, and drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. What's dumber than that is being a fan of Justine. Yeah, like you said earlier, I should have been swallowed. Yeah, no shit, because you're such a freaking twat waffle, you little douchebag. Beaver! What's dumber than that, though, is men slapping women or animal abuse or racism or people who watch on bets or fake friends or anybody that supports the fans who is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church or ISIS. Things like that are just plain stupid. And we deserve a big fat GFY. Wow, screwed that one up, didn't I? Don't worry, I'll be drinking shit beer on Yeehaw West on Wednesday. You'll see why. Little hint. But, folks, see you on 2 for Tuesday. And I forgot to mention my football pick for tonight. I get the Giants, the New York Eli Mannings, beating the Philadelphia Chip Kellys. About that much. It's going to be a good game, I think. I wish both teams could lose because I can't stand Chip Kelly. I can't stand Eli Manning. It's not that I hate the guy. He just whoops our asses. He always owns the Patriots. Chip Kelly, though. Enough said. And it's too bad because I like the Eagles. But, folks, talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Hey, represent the truth, Paul Pierce. Yeah, baby.